Dear all, I am Antoine Buck, a second-year PhD student working currently on methane dehydrogenations under non-oxidative conditions over bimetallic catalyst. These reactions allow decarbonizing methane into benzene with high selectivity while producing sustainable hydrogen. However, this reaction presents two major hurdles which hinder the industrialization of the process. The fast catalyst deactivation is still under ongoing investigation. For that reason, we perform traditional kinetic study with a fresh catalyst made of 3% molybdenum over HDSN5 zolite. On the left, we can see the catalytic test with the so-called deactivation step. From this data, it is possible to plot the deactivation constant calculated assuming a pseudokinetic order of 1 for each contact time. From on the right, we can see the spent catalyst characterizations recovered after 10 hours of reaction. The thermogravimetric analysis allows determining two weight losses. From this data, it is also possible to plot the concomitant as function of contact time. It appears that we have unconventional behavior. Indeed, as the contact time increases, we lower the concomitant and we have a better catalyst stability. So we decided to distinguish these two types of coke. On the left, we can see the soft coke, and its amount is totally independent of the deactivation constant. This type of coke is made of polyaromatic compound and is considered as a non-toxic type of coke and is a spectator in the reaction. On the right, we have the hard coke, and its amount is directly related on the deactivation constant. The hard coke is considered as a toxic type of coke and inhibits the active spaces by poisoning. The hard coke is made of naphthalene and benzene and plays a key role in the reaction. But why is amount decrease? Why its amount decrease with contact time? So it is important not to forget that we produce hydrogen in the reaction. The higher is the hydrogen production, the lower is the total coke amount. So we decided to perform modeling with the reaction, and we observed that when we adsorb benzene and hydrogen over the same active size, we reduce the strength of the benzene adsorption on the active size. So this new deactivation mode has been for the first time evidenced by our team. So thank you for watching. Have a pleasant European football championships and may the best wins. Cheers.